Welcome back. As promised, I have with me on the line via Skype is Dato' Sri Dr. Muhammad Huzaim Mahidin. He is the Chief Statistician of Malaysia. Dr. Huzaim, I take note of the tweet that you made today. You are indeed a prolific social media enthusiast, but of the many things that you tweet out, this graph that you shared was actually quite crucial and actually quite important, which is showing the rate of positive cases versus the rate of death versus the rate of recovery. And via the first two phases of the MCO, things are looking up. Could you explain to us how we move forward from here point onwards? Because what's the point of having data if to not show us the way forward? What do you think will be the new normal for Malaysia?
It's actually, we think about the after the COVID to back to the normal routine is not easy, especially the advice from the health authority that we have to maintain our social distance. Of course, the mass gathering is no longer attainable. We need to keep it in mind that, for example, to have socialized during the ceremonies, during the the wedding, of course, during the celebration, because this country is really used to a very great celebration when during the festival session season. So I think it is maybe will be changed dramatically. The same also the way how we celebrate for the Muslim Eid al-Fitri and also during the fasting month about the Ramadan. And in fact, if we flashback in 1970s, in 1980s, maybe we can see that the movement of the people out of the village is very limited during the period of time. I still remember we hardly travel for long journey during 1960, 1970, or even in early 1980s. So I think we may back to the what the scenario during that period. And of course, with the technology, I think we still can continue the very warm relationship, but not in the form of physical. But it's very interesting. Sometimes when you are not very meet regularly, you have a very strong feeling to each other because you're not really. And sometimes when in your big family also, sometimes I find that when you talk in the for example, in the WhatsApp group, some of the sibling or our grandchildren, they are very much participate, engaged during when you are not really meet face to face. I think it's a kind of the thing that I think we already get used into it. But of course, in terms of new normal, in terms of travel, in terms of doing the activity like sport will be a very much I'm not sure. I think it still remain uncertain how the football, how the Premier League will be, and also in the fact in the global arena, how the sport as the whole will be changed dramatically. But of course, in this environment, interconnected world, I think what been doing in one country, I will think the other country will be follow suit.
What do you think will be the forecasting moving forward? How do you think things will be, at least in the near term? Do you think that cases will spike, issues will change moving forward? Because we've had some forecasting done by other people, right? From MIER, the Malaysian Institute of Economic Research, from JP Morgan, MIUR, for instance, forecasted things to be 9,000 cases by mid-April. JP Morgan argues that, you know, if things don't change by mid-March, by mid-April, the forecasting will be about 6,500. These cases are actually quite disturbing. But as things transpired, things did not materialize to be that much. What's your forecasting on things like this moving forward?
Thank you. If we look at the how we manage this pandemic, I think I can say that we are we implemented a very good strategy. For example, as we know that this pandemic, they very much easier to spread if there are a lot or people stay in one area, what we call in statistics, called the level of intensity. So what has been done by the government, when the specific area, there are a lot of new cases, the more stringent MCO to be implemented to control the disease. It is something is a very, very great effort. Then I believe that the reason why we managed to mitigate the number of infection, the new cases, much lower than what been forecasted by JP Morgan and also the others agencies. Of course, when they made the forecasting, they have a lot of the assumption made in their modeling. And the more important also the model, sometimes they're not able to take into account everything, how the people react to the authorities. So I believe that in terms of this country, the people of the country in general, we can say that we react much better to the what been advised by the been the direction of the authority. I think this is something that we think that we are better off. And of course, compared to other country, I see that the use of the public transport to commute, that may contribute the much bigger the infection of the disease to the people. But in this country, I think the level of dependent on the public transport before the MCO also not as high as the developed country. That also maybe the why we can manage the number of infected disease among the people is lower than other country.
Okay, Dr. Uzi, just stay on the line for us for a bit. We'll take one more short break. When we come back, we'll discuss a little bit more about how we as the rakyat, as the people, can help the government and help authorities moving forward. Thanks very much. Stay on the line with us.